We just launched two new database providers for the Vercel Marketplace, which gives you a first-party integration into your database of choice with integrated billing in Vercel. So we now support Neon, Upstash, Supabase, Redis Cloud, EdgeDB, Nile, and Motherduck, and more to come. I'm super excited about this, and I want to show you a demo of how it works. So when you're inside of your Vercel application, you can click on storage and add any of these storage providers with this first-party integration. We also have some native storage options for Vercel, like Edge Config or Blob Storage. And we've worked over the past months to extend the previous Postgres and KV options that Vercel offered and open this up to many different providers. For example, if I want to use Supabase, I can click on Supabase. I can start with their free plan or their paid plan. So let's go with the free plan. I'm going to make this in US East. Supabase pink car. That sounds wonderful. I'm going to hit create and we're going to make our new database. So now on the Vercel dashboard, we're initializing our database. And you might have seen this view before if you've worked with databases on Vercel in the past. You can access your environment variables, you can configure some of the settings. But the new thing that we've added that's really powerful is that we have this button to open your database directly in the Supabase console. So we pop into the Supabase dashboard, we see that we're still setting up our database, we're spinning that up, and we can do pretty much everything in here as if we were going directly to Supabase itself. It's the same pricing, we have all the same options, you just have one nice unified bill through Vercel, and it's the same for all the other providers in the marketplace as well. So for example, maybe I want to go over and make a new table. Let's do users. That all looks good. We've got an ID. Maybe we'll throw a name on here and make that, we'll make that text. Yeah, that all looks good. We'll hit save. We're gonna make our new columns for our database. Boom, we're off and running. We could drop in some data through CSV here, or we could even just go and insert a row. Let's do auto ID, Lee Rob, hit save. Awesome. We've got a database, we've got a Postgres database with data up and running, fully connected to Vercel in just a few minutes. Back inside the Vercel dashboard, we can see the status is now available and we're on the free plan. So I'm gonna connect this to a project and we're gonna add the environment variables to connect to the database to all three of the environments inside of our application. So I'll hit connect here. That's gonna save those values. Great, that all looks good. So let me click on this project and go over to settings. And we can see all of the environment variables with the Supabase logo by them in our project. Now, another thing that's new that you might have missed is we now support custom environments as well. We of course have your development environment and your production environment, but you can now create any new environments that you want on Vercel. So maybe you want a staging environment, maybe you want it to track a specific branch, maybe you want it to attach a domain or not attach a domain. All of this is possible now through the UI. Previously, there had to be some custom workflows to enable this. So another nice little quality of life improvement here. But that's the Vercel Marketplace. We've got more providers coming, more database options. And in a follow-up video, I'm also going to show how you can take your Supabase database and use it inside of V0. So stay tuned for that. Peace.